done, and it's pretty seen many dangerous spots, as far as it seems to be obvious, but the mere fact that it hasn't been passed, that it doesn't really say that they are using. But what's concerned me about is that I think that our officers have been a bit of a spot in which we've tried to get any sense of that side of it, because at the moment, we're in a situation where, well, certainly I'm in a situation where I would like to have some direct professional guidance about prioritizing these things. Then you're in a difficult position of expecting to move off the door, or you'll be left with the system of bringing it to us, and us then supposed to be relating back to you where we think the priorities are. Frankly, I don't know what the engineer priorities are based on professional experience,
rather than my amateur input. Okay, thank you.
Just a couple of comments about the additional potential danger at times that I can sympathize with most of the things that I'm entirely possible for to do. All the things that I've seen from half human actions remain. And members will perhaps get better correspondence when they raise things. Officers such as myself. In the year 2000, there were 1,379 crashes on rural roads in one year alone in which people were injured. And by prioritising where we would spend what money, we reduced that by 66%. And there's always this difficulty about what everybody has the potential to be a very dangerous job, a dangerous occurrence.
So what's to be in danger in spending that £77,000 in area that's already important that we don't that's going to be covered by somebody else. It's going to be picked up by a Labour programme, it's going to be picked up by something else from there. So Martin's Lane is a priority for us, but a priority for reasons and the children got passed over in the country. And it's been done. It's mentioned on age a few times, but it's been done. That's been a priority that's followed by the way. Now, is that constituency money, or is that highway money, or is it central programme money, or what?
I would suggest that issues surrounding highway maintenance are broadly outside the scope of road safety. Although there are potholes that whether you want to invest in the sort of the general condition, highway condition, is not really part of road safety or sustainable transport or passengers and its provisions around it. So my understanding
going back to Bernie's point, we can pick, for example, two votes in this cap, doesn't matter, and spend all this money. There are other priority areas. What will then happen in those areas? Because if we all agree today on two votes anyway, and it's absolute unanimous consensus, that doesn't mean that the other votes are in recognition that are going to be attention at point. So what will happen with those roads once we've allocated this funding? And this is where a pothole in the road you can easily attach a road safety issue to. But at the same time, is there higher limits?
But you're not going
to
get
any sense
at all.
No, I mean,
you know that I'm going to find. I'm going to find £13,000 for what we're talking about. Whatever it takes, I will fight for that money. There won't be consensus if you want to spend it elsewhere. I will fight for that.
Even if there was consensus, it's still
the money. Sorry, well, that's the truth. If you reach for £13,000, they know what to do with it. They talk to officers. They'll deal with it, but the rest of the street will spend it wisely.
And each war is.
Well, I'm leaving that here. Do we split it 6 weeks?
You moved that previously,
oh,
so we're not here to go.
I'm totally sure I'm continuing to move it until I get that way.
Well, you comments are noted.
So,
well, what
sorry, Chair, I've only moved something. You can't give no comments. Have I got a second? Thank you.
Right. Okay.
So, Chair,
there's a proposal there to split the money 6 ways. Those in favour? Those against?
So this here comes to go safety on islands 39. Sorry, I did have my address. Can I just ask? This list, can we have the things taken off it that are not suitable for the choice we're making today? That would be really helpful. Because some of these are factual resurfacing, which is obviously presumably not going to come out of the head of road safety, or and if we can have potholes taken out as well, and if we can have things like I don't know, for certain wards or roads, you know, it can be have things that are costed up that actually come out of the criteria of what the money is meant for, that would be really helpful.
To be fair, we've wasted 14 minutes on an incomplete report. We don't know the circles.
Yeah.
Let's just move on, close this off. Ask officers to bring that report. It's appropriate, it's complete, and then it's informative. Until that time, we do not.
Yeah, just that they finish.
As I understand it, the structural maintenance work is the issues that members brought forward as the constituency manager and asked for what would you like to fund completely. I thought it would be the same issues. The lending scores that the members have brought forward to the members what we want to have to do with the dollars, which of those offices can take them back to that work. It is kind of a
can I also just clarify some points when it says all roads in Monmouth and sort of Russell? The reasoning behind that is when we were first asked to nominate roads and local residents or residents were given to council officers, the council officers' response was, you all councils have less bad roads than done. So the blame was put fairly back on us. I'm not happy with that. So I've got all roads, Monmouth and sort of Russell. So everyone's streets are better. If Fox would want to play that game, then they'll do all roads.
Really agree with Chris regarding the way the reports are put together, but even the narratives where it's got officers' comments, if actionable, will be repaired to me at the end. What does that mean? Yeah. Repaired from where? Repaired from what? I've just got no idea.
And is that all due to sort of this is information provided by colleagues of mine, which I apologise on the record on all that lack of clarity. These were comments made by the inspectors in question. Those I would have expected to be in the table as part of regular maintenance were prioritised within that regular maintenance.
Yeah, and I think that's a whole confusion about this.
Okay, I don't know if that's it. I think we'll move on, but I'll say the same thing. So basically, what we're doing is
just one point of information. Yeah. It's a question, really. Local authority statutory duty to provide road safety. Nowhere in that information does it mention recording of any misses.
There is no requirement for the misses under the statutes that exist.
So obviously the next question from that then is the criteria for installation of road safety measures requires a fatality or a serious incident? Any recording of near misses would logically, progressively indicate to any professional what the situation is with that particular issue. And if you're not recording them, you haven't then got a full rounded picture with all the information that clearly identifies a dangerous area. It's just something that
I understand the frustration, and it's a frustration I share entirely. The Department of Transport produce guidance figures around for every incident where somebody is injured, the current estimates are that there are some 70 national figures, there are 70 universities that don't want to be reported somewhere. There's no national system to require drivers to provide information in any kind of places to say what there is a system here. And you can then start to see consistent information coming through, the priorities might change. We've still got a whole range of locations that do have casualty problems, junctions and locations where we've got casualties in the day, but we do have good information reported by the police. They were the priorities, so slight injuries, serious injuries, and most fatalities. I was hoping to look at one trying to hone in on what those priorities are.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks very much. We'll move on now to agenda item 4. Request for problem solving funding engagements and market activity.
This is a request for the working group to consider an allocation from the Mrs. Comp Solve to
please.
Without having to spend £1,000. And I just don't see the reason
for having to spend £1,000 when we have all that information that we get out to people anyway. And what we're getting out to people is a great way. I don't see spending £1,000 for making them more. So my purpose is to.
Okay, Paul.
Thanks, sir. Just in terms of the genesis of this issue, in the previous series of forums, we weren't expecting to fund our own publicity. You say you've gone back and reflected on it, come back and asked for around about £1,000, although it's costed, and then we're supposed to give you that money out of a pot which, you know, we should be spending, in my opinion, on other things. So why is it that no longer the centrally the council fund that type of activity? When was that decision made? When was it communicated to you and who by basically? And secondly, you know, the way you've gone about it, reflecting upon these points, just to give us a roundabout figure, at the end of the day, it's county taxpayers' money we're talking about here. We can't just give you authority to spend a roundabout figure when we don't actually know what you want to spend it on. It's not petty cash, it's council taxpayers' money. So, I mean, the agreement, I don't think we should agree to that this evening.
Adrian.
Well, Chair, I spent most of the last 55 or so years of my life in publicising things that were going to happen, and I then kept it afterwards to say what I spent money on, and people generally trusted me to do that, and most of the organisations I've been involved in, including some very large charities and various others, always assumed that there's a pot of money which the professional officers will spend professionally in order to publicise things. And it seems to me that we ought to trust them to spend some, to have a pot of money, which they may or may not use, and then tell us after what we spent it on. It seems to be entirely reasonable.
I really ought to have the opposite for the reason to think about anything that's spent from part of the committee. We should agree in this.
I think Chris made a very, very valid point that only three people come to these meetings in the past, and I think if you can spend £1,000 to highlight this and get more of the public there, it would be £1,000 well spent. But we've got to start seeing what we don't see, so we've got to start seeing the public engaging in this, and I think it's down to all of us as members to encourage people to do everything we can to try and get them. So if £1,000 helps and encourages that, because you're right, there are loads of places that we can advertise, but we've still got to have materials to advertise and people to deliver that material.
That's what you've got to do
You've said up to £1,000, so let's see where we go. But you know, we've got to do everything we can. If this system is going to work, we've got to do everything we can to try and engage with the public. And engage with the public in all of our wards.
Our only time in the area, or when our new passes,
This is what I don't understand, and I'd like Caroline to answer my questions, please, in relation to why we now as a forum need to fund publicity, because the area forums previously were advertised fairly extensively in church groups, community groups, and groups such as mentioned by Evan himself as a community group, and also just general passing information on to those members of the public who didn't come and see us. So what is it you're going to do differently? How much will that cost? But more importantly, when was the decision made that the owners will now be on the constituency committees to pay for that themselves? The council are heralding these new constituency committees as a way of spending money on the constituencies and in terms of road safety and these other projects, not so we can spend money on the sand ourselves. So I don't get where that decision was made, who might,